So good evening everyone, this is Dr. Vineet Sehgal and welcome to our next series of the clinical case discussion. And today we would be talking about two important lid disorders, that is the ectropion and the entropion. Okay, so first I would discuss the ectropion, and then in the next video we would take tomorrow I would discuss the entropion. So basically, why these two disorders, the ectropion and entropion, they are important? Because with age, okay, if you have some lid abnormalities, what it can cause is it can basically decrease not your quantity of vision, but it would basically have an effect on your quality of life. The ectropion and entropion, they are the most commonly seen lid abnormalities. So we would see how a case of ectropion presents in your OPD. How would you diagnose the case of ectropion? What should be the clinical tests that has to be done? What are the types of ectropion and what is the brief management strategy of the ectropion? So I would not go into the detail of the ectropion surgeries, how they are done, but I would basically make you clear what are the questions that can be asked in the ectropion and how you should evaluate a patient of ectropion. Okay, so if you can see me, if you can hear my voice clearly, just give me a thumbs up so that I can start the session. Okay, so with this, I would be starting the session on ectropion. Okay, so let's move that if we have got the slides now. So I told you whenever you have to basically start your case discussion, whenever you have a long case, you have to go with these headings. First, you have to tell about the demographic profile of the patient, followed by the chief complaints of the patient. Then you would go with the history, where you would talk about the history of present illness. You would describe the various chief complaints. Then you have to talk about the history of past illness, personal history, and then you would go to the family history. Then you would do a clear general examination, and after the general examination, you would go with the ocular examination, followed by the provisional diagnosis that you made. If there are some other diagnoses that can be made, this is called differential diagnosis, followed by the investigations that you would do for basically this pathology, and then what would be your final management strategy. Okay, so these are the basic headings through which we have to always discuss our long case. Okay, so those students who have just joined now, you can see all my lectures on the Unacademy Learning app. And if you are a NEET PG aspirant, from yesterday, we have started the NEET PG Season 1 batch, INICD MCQ batch, Target Next 2022 batch, and the FMG Test and Analysis batch. You can join it by using my code OFTHEL10 to enroll into the PLUS program. Okay, so I would be coming to the first topic, the first heading that we have to see, the demography. Now, why the demography is important when you are basically examining a case of ectropion? So let's say the patient is a 26-year-old patient and he has come to the ectropion. If the patient is a 60-year-old patient and he has come with the ectropion, so what is the difference? So the pathology which can be there in a 26-year-old patient, it cannot be a degenerative pathology. It can be something which is after an injury, after a scarring, or it may be a mass effect of some disorder. Okay, but if you think that the pathology is in the 60 year age group or 65 year age group, then you think that this patient may be having something which is more correlated to the degeneration of the lower lid muscles. Okay, the lower lid muscles which keep the eyelid opposed to your eyeball, they may be deficient or they may be having some degenerative condition. So that is why the demography. And in the demography, the age is most important criteria. Okay, so I write it here. There is my pen. Okay, fair enough. I got my pen. So in age, why important? We know that whether it is a senile or I would say involutional ectropion, or if it is something which is there in the young person, which may be due to any mass effect, any trauma, or any cicatrization. Okay, so that's why I need to know the age. The other things which we have to mention is the sex and the address, not of much significance. Then if I show you, the patient picture is like this. If you can see this picture, just give me a thumbs up. So all these images that I show you in my videos, in my OPD, these are the real clinical images. They are not from something which is Google. So they are most close to the questions that can be asked in your exam. Okay, so you are not getting something which is a albino or something from a US patient who has got, and you have got a picture like this. These are your own patients from your own clinic. Okay, so if you can see in this picture, this is the eyelid margin. If you can appreciate, just give me a thumbs up. तो आपको दिख रहा है कि ये आईलिड मार्जिन है, ये सुपीरियर है, ये इंफीरियर है, ठीक है? ये हमारा कॉर्निया है और ये कॉर्निया के साथ हमारा हल्का सा लिम्बस है. सो व्हाट यू कैन सी इज दैट देयर इज अ इवर्जन ऑफ द आईलिड मार्जिन्स. ओके, सो व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू टेल यू हियर इज, इफ दिस इज माय आईबॉल, यूजुअली आईलिड मार्जिन्स शुड बी अपोज टू इट, बट हियर यू कैन सी the eyelid margins are not opposed. Okay, so this is a patient of ectropion. If you can appreciate this feature, just give me a thumbs up. Why it is important? Because in this picture, the management that you would do, okay, the classification that you would do, it depends upon where is the eversion, how much is the eversion, and what is the age of the patient, what is the suitability of the patient for going with the surgery in this patient. Okay, so how the patient would present to you, what can be the chief complaints of this patient, can you write in the complaint in the comment section? So my question is ki is tarah ka agar aapka patient aata hai to usko kya complaints ho sakti hain. Just try to see. Yes, definitely there can be a watering, there can be a redness, and because of this, what is happening is that your palpebral conjunctiva, can you appreciate, this is my palpebral conjunctiva, and this palpebral conjunctiva is now basically in the contact with your environment, which usually is protected. Okay, so there can be a congestion of this palpebral conjunctiva, or there can be an inflammation of this palpebral conjunctiva. So there can be a conjunctivitis, and because now your puncta is also open to the environment, there can be a punctal stenosis, okay, or there can be a cicatrization of the puncta. So that's why your nasolacrimal system, that would not be working well. So tumhara jo lacrimal pump mechanism hai wo utna acha nahi hoga. So, जो ड्रेनेज सिस्टम है वो उतना अच्छा नहीं होगा. सो दैट्स वाई द पेशेंट्स मे ऑल्सो कम एंड ही सेज सर मुझे बहुत वॉटरिंग होती है, पेशेंट ये बोलेगा, ठीक है. सो दीज आर द साइंस दैट यू कैन गेट, और आई वुड से द क्लिनिकल फीचर्स दैट यू वुड गेट इन द पेशेंट ऑफ द एक्ट्रोपियन. ओके, देन वी हैव द पिक्चर लाइक दिस, आई हैव टोल्ड यू. सो कैन यू टेल मी वन फाइंडिंग दैट हियर आई एम सीइंग इज एक्ट्रोपियन. Any other finding that you can see in this picture? So let's see some clinical skill of you. So definitely there is the rolling of the margins outside. We can see a small amount of congestion also. So I write it here. This patient ko ectropion hai. Aur kya hai isko? Thoda sa conjunctivitis bhi hai. And if you can see the whitening of these eyelashes. Okay, what is this term that is basically used for whitening of these eyelashes? I call it pollucis. Okay, I call it pollucis. So these are the features that we see in the patients who are having a, let's say, a senile or involutional ectropion. Okay. So, eyelash deposits नहीं है यार, ये eyelash थोड़ी सी white हैं जिसको हम poliosis कहते हैं. Okay, then the comes the history of present illness. Whenever you have to present the history of present illness, why it is important is that what you have to do is you have to basically explain your chief complaints. Okay, you have to explain your chief complaints in this patient. So that's why this is so important to you, that whatever the complaints that you have put, you basically describe it. You tell what is the duration and how it presented, for how long it is, and if there is some associated complaint as well. So how I would present this case, if I am the student, so I would basically present with the case with patient presented with, let's say, watering and redness of the lid margins. Okay, the patient also told that this lid margins are gradually turning outward. Okay, so one, it can be a senile, so that would be a gradual ectropion, or it can be a sudden one. Sudden kahan par hoga? Let's say you are having a Sika trichal type of ectropion, there you would be having a case where you would be having a sudden outward turning of the lid margin. Okay, and then you also say that, sir, in this patient there is no diminution of vision which can be a complaint. Okay, so that is how you can basically present the history of present illness. Okay, then what are the things which you have to tell about the history of past illness? In the past illness, the most important thing that you have to tell is that if there is a history of any previous lid surgery, okay, let's say patient ko ek basal cell carcinoma tha aur aapne inferiorly basal cell carcinoma ko remove kiya. The patient was suffering from a basal cell carcinoma and you had done a excision of the mass of basal cell carcinoma. This has basically caused the damage to your lid retractors. So that is why the inferior ectropion is there. Remember, ectropion usually, or I would say 99.9% of the cases, it is inferiorly. Okay, so you would not see me telling you about the upper lid anatomy. It would be the lower lid anatomy that would be so useful for you. The second thing that you have to remember is that in the history of past illness, here you also tell if there is a history of trauma or if there is a history of any chemical injury to the face. Okay, why this is important? Because this can lead to a cicatrical ectropion. Agar itna samajh mein aa gaya hai till now, just give me a thumbs up. If this part is clear to all of you. Okay, then not very much important, just tell that there is no drug history and there is no family history also in the patient. One thing more that I just forgot to tell you, that also take the history of any bleeding diathesis. Now you would ask me, sir, why it is important? It is basically important because in these patients you need to go for a surgery, and during the surgery if there is excessive bleeding, what it can cause is, it can cause a life-threatening condition. Okay, so whenever you are doing a lid surgery or any ocular surgery, you also have to take the history if the patient is basically taking any warfarin or if the patient is taking any aspirin or heparin. So important in now these COVID scenarios that the patient should be having a good history, historical background, that you should not do some harm to the patient. Okay, so that's why it is so important for all of you. Chal. Then we come to the general examination. In the general examination, nothing much to be taken care of. You tell about the gait of the patient, the nutrition of the patient, and in the ophthal you just have to comment for that, because some professors want ki aapne general examination kiya bhi hai ya nahi kiya hai. So you tell that CVS system seems to be normal, respiratory seems to be normal, the patient is well oriented to time, place and person, and per abdominal also there is no abnormality that is basically seen in the patient. Okay, not very much important, but definitely for those third year students who are attending the session, that is something you should write in your case sheet. Okay, then we come to the ocular, a general ocular examination. Whenever you do a ocular examination, you always have to tell what is the vision of the patient. for the distance as well as for the near, you have to mention it, and then you tell that how is your palpebral conjunctiva. Okay, palpebral conjunctiva, if you have a patient of ectropion, always comment on that. Okay, why it is important? Because this patient, because the palpebral conjunctiva is sometimes exposed, it can be congested and there can be a conjunctivitis there. Okay, also in your eyelid, we would discuss the eyelid again and again. Okay, I would discuss it in detail. You have to basically tell about the puncta also. What is the meaning of puncta? Puncta basically have is the first structure in your nasolacrimal system. These are the openings through which our canals basically drain your tear film into the lacrimal sac. Okay, we have the upper puncta. With that, we have the upper canaliculi. We have the lower puncta and we have the lower canaliculi. Then we have the common canaliculi opening into the lacrimal sac. Okay, so that is why these are very, very important points that you have to basically put it in your examiner's mind ki sir humne jo hai wo puncta bhi dekha aur conjunctiva bhi dekha. Then a general examination with your slit lamp, you tell about the cornea, lens and iris. But remember, the viva would not go into the cornea, lens and iris, but whenever you are doing a ocular examination, you are presenting a case, all the headings, anterior chamber, vitreous, retina, macula, optic nerve head, you definitely have to mention. Then I come to the specific examination that you would do for the ectropion. So first of all, what it is important is why, how I define a ectropion. Okay, so it is a very common eyelid anomaly, and I, as I told you, it is more commonly seen in the lower lid. It is more commonly seen in the lower lid, and what it means is, it means outward turning of or outward rolling of the lid margin. As I told you, this is my eyeball and this is my eyelid margin. So kaise ja raha hai? Outward ja raha hai. This is outward turning of the lid margin. Okay, this is called ectropion. Now why the ectropion occurs? As I told you, 99% of the cases you are having a lower lid ectropion. So jo lower lid mein eyelid ko isse chipka ke rakhta hai, wo kaun se structures hote hain? So my question is, what are those structures called which basically make the eyelid opposed to the eyeball? Can anyone tell me? What are these structures? So these structures are called lower lid retractors. Okay, so whenever there is a deficiency in the lower lid retractors, what this causes is, this causes your ectropion. So what is these lower lid retractors? They basically make a capsulopalpebral fascia. Okay, so I write, they basically make a capsulopalpebral fascia, which is a fibrous tissue which arises from various structures. Okay, so if you can see here, if you can see, this is your, if you can see this one, I just pointed here. Can you see, Rahul, this structures? So this is your capsulopalpebral fascia. In the capsulopalpebral fascia, the main things that you have to remember which makes the capsulopalpebral fascia, these are the inferior rectus and the inferior oblique muscles. Okay, and your suspensory ligament of Lockwood, and your one thing that is left here is the tarsus muscle. Okay, the inferior tarsal muscle. These all structures, they in combination form the capsulopalpebral fascia, and the capsulopalpebral fascia is the main structure which is responsible for the lower lid retractors. Now, two more important anatomical features that you have to remember whenever we talk about the ectropion is the medial canthal tendon and the lateral canthal tendon. Now, where is the medial and lateral canthal tendon? So basically, do not get confused too much into the anatomy. They would not be asking about too much of the eyelid anatomy. But yahan tak ye samajh lena ki jo medial canthal tendon hai, wo this one. Can you see the two horns here? So this is your medial canthal tendon and this is your lateral canthal tendon. Okay, I write MCT and LCT. Okay, these are the two tendons which are responsible for basically attachment of the muscles of the orbicularis. Okay, so orbicularis muscle has two parts. Okay, do not go into too much of anatomy. I just tell you, orbicularis muscle, the muscle which basically closes the eyelid, that has two parts. One is a preseptal and the other one is pretarsal. Now, funda yahan par hai that whenever we talk about the medial canthal tendon, this one, it basically represents the insertion of these preseptal and pretarsal parts of the orbicularis muscle. Whenever we talk about the lateral canthal tendon, it basically represents the origin of pretarsal and the preseptal portions of the orbicularis muscle. These are two very, very important points regarding the MCT, the medial canthal tendon and the lateral canthal tendon. Why it is important? Because depending upon the medial canthal tendon and the lateral canthal tendon, we have the different tests and we also tell what can be the management in these patients. Okay, so as I told you, the patient would come with irritation, watering and some redness of the lid margins. That can be your clinical features. Now we come to the specific lid examination. In the lid examination, I told always tell about the associated lid findings. Okay, so associated lid findings, jaise maine aapko bataya, is patient mein there is a polyosis, okay, that is the grayish eyelashes, and also there is a punctal stenosis, or I can say keratinization of the puncta. So the first test we do is called a pinch test. What is the meaning of pinch test? So see here, what I do is I basically pinch my lower lid. Okay, so if this lid can be pulled more than 6 millimeter, this means that the lid is lax. Are you getting my point? So I would just show you a video also if it is available. So see here, I am just pinching it. Now you can see this is a normal person, and in this patient I am not able to basically pinch more than 6 millimeter. Agar hum more than 6 millimeter isko pinch kar lete hain, lower lid aage chali jati hai. So this means that this patient is having a lid laxity. Are you getting my point? So this is called pinch test or the distraction test. Okay. So the next test is basically, I just show you it here again. See, I am basically pinching it and then I am pinch kiya aur chhod diya. Jaise hi pinch karke maine choda, ye wapas jaake eyeball se mil gaya. Okay, so this is basically the second test which is called snap test. Okay, so what happens in the snap test? Humne khicha aur chhod diya. So as soon as I basically release the lid, it goes back into its original position. This is called snap test. So dekho, ek hi test mein humne do cheeze kar li. Pehli cheez, first I thought that this patient is having a ectropion because of the lid laxity. So agar 6 millimeter se dur chala gaya, so definitely there is a lid laxity. Aur agar wapas jane mein bhi time leta hai, to iska matlab isme jo hai lid laxity confirm hai. So ye do test hote hain jo ki hamari lid laxity batate hain. Is it clear everyone? What is the lid laxity? Then the next test we do is the medial canthal tendon laxity. Okay, I told you the medial canthal tendon. What makes the medial canthal tendon? I told it is basically insertion of which muscle? It is insertion of the pre-tarsal and pre-septal part of which muscle? Tell me. Orbicularis. Okay, it is the preseptal and pre-tarsal part of orbicularis, which is the medial canthal tendon. Okay, so what I do is hum lower lid ko laterally leke jaate hain. So I pull the lower lid laterally and see the displacement of the lower puncta. This is your eyeball. Okay, this is your lower puncta. I pull it laterally and this is my limbus. Okay, see, this is my limbus. So if I can pull it so much that this basically can reach here, this means that there is a medial canthal tendon laxity. So yahan pe aapko lag raha hai ki jahan par bhi hamara medial canthal tendon ya lower lid retractor weak hai, so there is a basically weakness of the lower lid retractor or the medial canthal tendon. This causes your ectropion. So I would just show you the video also. So see, what I am doing is I try to push the medial canthus laterally, but the medial canthal is at its position. Okay, so ye ek normal patient hai, ye ectropion nahi hai, to normally ye lower lid tak nahi jata hai pankta. Okay, so this is called which test? This is called medial canthal tendon test. Is it clear to you, all of you? Okay, then we have the next test. So I just show you again. See, I am trying to move the puncta laterally, but it is not going. This is called a medial canthal tendon test. Okay, then the next test is the lateral canthal tendon test. Okay, so what is the lateral canthal tendon test? In lateral canthal tendon test, okay, so I am do not have the video, I just tell you theoretically here. The lateral canthal tendon, that what happens here is horizontal palpebral aperture. Okay, so what is the horizontal palpebral aperture? This is the horizontal aperture. I make it with another pen. This is my horizontal palpebral aperture. This horizontal palpebral aperture, this is shortened. Okay, ye chota ho jayega apne diameter mein. Normal diameter kitna hota hai horizontal palpebral aperture ka? Around 28 to 30 millimeter. Okay, and the distance between the temporal limbus and lateral canthal tendon, okay, this is decreased. Okay, so what I say here is, let's say this is my lateral canthal tendon and this is my temporal limbus. So this distance, this is basically decreased in the lateral canthal tendon laxity. Okay, so these are the various tests that we do whenever we have a patient of ectropion. I again tell you once again all these tests. The first test is pinch test. Pinch test mein hum kya karenge? Hum lower lid ko pinch karenge eyelid se dur. So this is, if it is more than 6 millimeter, this means that the pinch test is positive. This means the patient is having a lower lid laxity. What is the second test? The second test we basically do is the snap test. So snap test mein hum kya karenge, hum dekhenge pehle hum pinch kar lenge aur pinch karne ke baad usko chhod denge. We release the lower lid, and when we release the lower lid, if it goes back instantly, then this means there is no lower lid laxity. But if there is a delay in the lower lid going back, this means the snap test is positive, there is a lower lid laxity. Then the third test is the test which is called medial canthal tendon laxity. Hum medial can hum lower lid ko jo hai laterally push karenge. Or if our the lower puncta it is going up to the nasal limbus, then it means there is a medial canthus tendon laxity. Lateral canthal tendon laxity hum kaise show karenge? If we have to show the LCT, the lateral canthal tendon laxity, then we see the distance between the temporal limbus and the lateral canthus. If this is decreased, or our whole horizontal palpebral aperture, this is also decreased, this means the patient is having a lateral canthal tendon laxity. Give me a thumbs up if you are able to understand these points. तो ये चार टेस्ट होते हैं जो कि आपको बताने हैं अगर आपको एक्ट्रोपियन का एक शॉर्ट केस मिल जाता है. ओके, सो देन वी कम टू द नेक्स्ट टेस्ट विच इज कॉल्ड इंफीरियर स्क्लेरल शो. इफ यू कैन सी इन दिस पिक्चर, सो व्हाट यू सी इज दैट दिस इज नॉर्मली व्हाट हैपेंस इज व्हेन यू हैव अ नॉर्मल पर्सन. सो this is my eyelid margin. It basically covers 2 millimeter of the superior cornea, but the eyelid margins, they are in touch with your inferior limbus. ठीक है, जो नीचे वाली eyelid होती है वो cornea के limbus के जो है उससे touch करती है. Is it clear everyone? This is a normal person. What happens in a ectropion is you can see the inferior sclera. Can you see the inferior sclera? Everyone just give me a thumbs up. So humko inferiorly jo sclera hai wo dikhai de rahi hai. This is called scleral show. This can also happen. Remember, it is not very specific for the ectropion. This can be also seen in the thyroid ophthalmopathy. This can be seen in the proptosis also. Okay? So, but yes, inferior scleral show can be seen even in these patients who are having a ectropion. Then I told you there can be in the lacrimal system, there can be a keratinization or punctal stenosis. Okay, keratinization of the puncta plus jo puncta ki opening hai wo itni choti ho jayegi ki dikhegi nahi. So there can be a punctal stenosis also because of that. Okay, so these are some important things which you have to basically do in the examination of the ectropion. Okay, so what are the, I am just analyzing and telling you one by one all the clinical examination findings that you have to basically tell in a case of ectropion. You have to identify the defects in the various components of the eyelid. तो जो भी मैंने टेस्ट बताया इन चारों टेस्ट के बारे में बताना है तुमको, स्नैप टेस्ट बताना है तुम्हें, पिंच टेस्ट बताना है तुमको, एमसीटी और जो है एलसीटी के बारे में बताना है. देन यू लुक फॉर द आईलिड, वेदर द आईलिड इज क्लोजिंग और नॉट क्लोजिंग. समटाइम्स एक्ट्रोपियन इज देयर विद द सेवेंथ नर्व पेल्सी ऑल्सो. ओके, सो यू सी दैट वेदर देयर इज अ लैग ऑफ थैलमस और नॉट. देन इफ देयर इज अ इंफीरियर लिड स्किन, देयर इज अ एक्सेस लिड स्किन, ओके, दैट कैन ऑल्सो कॉज अ pressure and that can cause ectropion. Okay, as I told you, you have to tell about the lateral canthal tendon and the medial canthal tendon laxity. If there is a mass lesion, I told you when I started the session, if there is something which is a basal cell carcinoma or any type of mass lesion, you have to tell about that. And if there is any scarring, why the scarring is important? Because of the cicatrical type of ectropion. So if there is a localized or generalized scarring, let's say there is a chemical injury, an acid attack victim, so you have to tell that sir there is a localized scarring inferiorly jiski wajah se jo patient ko jo hai wo ectropion hai. Okay, so these are the most important points regarding the examination of a patient of ectropion. If you have any doubt till now, just let me know in the comment section so that I can go to the management part. अभी तक अगर आपको कोई डाउट है या शुड आई गो टू द मैनेजमेंट पार्ट. So I would just now go to the management part. Before I go to the management part, I would be just telling that if you are planning to take the Unacademy Plus subscription, then there is a good news for you. For the 3 month subscription, you would get a 1 month extra free. Also for the Iconic subscription, you would be having, for 3 year subscription, if you are a third year student, you would get a lot of discount in that. So 3 year subscription, not on 92,000 rupees, it is just for a 58,500 rupees. Okay, so this is the one which is the offer for you, which if you are going for the comprehensive PG preparation. Okay, chalo, with this I basically go to the management part of the Ectropion. So before I start the management, there is the, what are the grades of Ectropion? Okay, you should know the grades of Ectropion. So pehli cheez mein kya hota hai ki, just if the whole eyelid, the eye, what I showed you was a grade 3 Ectropion. But if let's say there is only, you can see a puncta which is everted, okay, to aapko sirf puncta eversion dikhai de raha hai, baki sab kuch bilkul normal hai. So this is called grade 1 Ectropion, okay, this is called a punctal eversion, a grade 1 Ectropion. In grade 2, what happens, this is your eyelid margin, this is your eyelid margin, and you can just see the eyelid margin from the outside, okay, aapko posterior eyelid margin jo hai. So Rahul, I am coming to the classification also. So aapko sirf posterior eyelid margin dikhai de raha hai, to what this is called is, this is called a grade 2 Ectropion, okay. Then we have the grade 3 Ectropion. In grade 3 Ectropion, not only the posterior lid margin you are seeing, you are also seeing the palpebral conjunctiva here, okay. So the palpebral conjunctival exposure is also seen. This is the grade 3. And finally, itna zyada aapko Ectropion ho gaya hai ki you can see the fornices also, okay. Fornice kya hota hai? Palpebral or bulbar conjunctiva ka junction. Agar bahar se aapko fornix bhi dikhai de rahe hain, so this is called a grade 4 type of Ectropion. Is it clear? So this is called a grade 4 type of Ectropion. So whenever you present your case, you have to, the second thing that your examiner can ask you, which type of Ectropion it is. It is a grade 1, grade 2, grade 3 or grade 4 Ectropion. Is it clear, Rahul? Okay, then we come to the types of Ectropion. The most common type that you can see in your YY is the involutional Ectropion. Okay, this is the most common. Why it is happening? It is basically happening because of the laxity of the eyelid and the, basically there is a lengthening of your tendons with age. Okay, then we have the one that I told you is the cicatrical Ectropion. Okay, let's say there is a scarring, then we can have a paralytic Ectropion, a mechanical because of some mass lesion. Very, very rarely, I have not seen, I have just seen it in the books, not my practical. We can have a congenital Ectropion, and sometimes because of the spastic contraction. Okay, so hamari jo lower lid retractors hain, uske saath jo hai hamari jo muscles hain, wo jo hamari lower lid ko niche ki taraf lati hai, unka ekdam se contraction ho jaye. Okay, so there is a spastic contraction of the lower lid muscles, then this also causes the Ectropion, which is called spastic Ectropion. Is it clear? So these are the types of Ectropion that you can have in your clinic, and whenever you basically start your discussion, you have to classify which type of Ectropion it is. Is it clear, Rahul? Okay, so after this, what happens is, then I told you where is your, why there is an involutional Ectropion. The involutional Ectropion basically happens because of generalized lower lid laxity, and there is a, basically the your this one, your lengthening of the tendons. Okay, So I write it here, दो factors, एक lower lid laxity और दूसरा factor क्या है, दूसरा factor है हमारा lengthening of the tendons. चलो एंड देन यू वुड आस्क व्हाई इट इज हैपनिंग. दिस इज बिकॉज ऑफ द एज, माइक्रो इन्फार्क्ट्स और देयर इज अ एज रिलेटेड एट्रोफी. ओके, समटाइम्स व्हाई इट हैपेंस इज, जो मैं आपको प्रैक्टिकली बता रहा हूँ व्हाई इट हैपेंस इज, मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स व्हाट आई सी इज, आई एम अ ग्लोकोमा स्पेशलिस्ट इन शार्प साइड ग्रुप ऑफ आई हॉस्पिटल्स एंड आई गिव अ लॉट ऑफ एंटी ग्लोकोमा मेडिकेशन एंड दे आर नॉट वेरी गुड फॉर द ऑक्युलर सर्फेस. तो मैं देखता हूँ कि पेशेंट आता है, उसने आई ड्रॉप डाली, आफ्टर पुटिंग द आई ड्रॉप ही रब्स द आई. ओके, सो सी ही रब्स द आई. तो जब रब कर रहे हैं आई को तो हम डैमेज कर रहे हैं ना, तो हम उसको इवर्ट कर रहे हैं. सो दैट्स व्हाई आल्सो समटाइम्स द एक्ट्रोपियन अकर्स इन द ओल्ड इंडिविजुअल. सो इट कैन बी योर सेकेंडरी इफेक्ट्स ऑफ द कंजंक्टाइवल इरिटेशन. ओके, सो इट कैन बी योर सेकेंडरी इफेक्ट्स ऑफ द कंजंक्टाइवल इरिटेशन. सो वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू द पेशेंट इज, यू टेल द पेशेंट कि डू नॉट रब योर आईज. Okay, do not rub your eyes, a very important point. Is it clear? Now we go to the management of the patient. Now management of the patient of the ectropion, you can see my video specially which I have taken in the plus courses regarding the ectropion and entropion. Here I would be just telling you the basic things which are, if you go in your viva, agar aap uske treatment ectropion ki surgery pe pahunch gaye ho to iska matlab hai gold medal milne wala hai. Okay, so normally your examiner does not go into so much detail, but the surgery of the ectropion, this residents at least should know. Okay, so I would be just telling you about the basic management of the involutional, that is the most common type of ectropion. So first is, if there is a mild to moderate ectropion. Mild to moderate ectropion ka kya matlab hua? Ki aapka grade 1 ectropion hai. ओके, ग्रेड 1 या ग्रेड 2 है जिसमें आपकी पंक्टल जो थोड़ा सा इवर्जन हुआ है और साथ में आपका पोस्टीरियर लिड मार्जिन देख रहा है. सो व्हाट यू डू इज, यू डू अ पेंटागनल वेज रिसेक्शन. ओके, सो पेंटागनल वेज रिसेक्शन. सो मैं छोटा सा, वैसे मेरी हैंडराइटिंग काफी खराब है, सो आई जस्ट मेक अ स्मॉल डायग्राम फॉर यू. सो दिस इज माई आई, सो आई मेक अ रिसेक्शन लाइक दिस. ओके, अ रिसेक्शन लाइक दिस. And then what I do is, after this resection, तो थोड़ा छोटा हो गया, then I suture it. Then I suture it like this. Okay? So what this I call a pentagonal wedge resection. Okay? Also the name is BIC procedure. Can you understand this? I know the if you are a third year student, it would be difficult for you, but just understand it. Okay? ज़्यादा याद करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. The second procedure which you can do is a called Kundt-Swarovski procedure. Okay, naam hi itna mushkil hai. So what we do is that in Kundt-Swarovski procedure, we basically not only take this whole wedge, we also basically remove the skin beneath it. Okay, so humne ye jo block hai, humne ye block to le hi liya, saath mein jo niche ki skin hai, जो एक्स्ट्रा फोल्ड ऑफ स्किन, मैंने आपको बताया था ना कि देयर कैन बी अ स्किन लैक्सिटी. सो इफ देयर इज अ स्किन विच इज आउटसाइड, एक्स्ट्रा स्किन, सो हमने वो एक्स्ट्रा स्किन भी निकाल दी. एंड सो डिफिकल्ट टू बेसिकली नेम द प्रोसीजर, द नेम ऑफ द प्रोसीजर इज Kundt-Szymanowski प्रोसीजर. कितना मुश्किल है ना. सो जस्ट कैन यू राइट इट, अगर इतना प्रोनाउंस नहीं होता है तो जस्ट यू राइट KZ प्रोसीजर. ओके, सो KZ प्रोसीजर इज समथिंग विच इज द सिमिलर टू द वेज रिसेक्शन दैट वी हैव डन अ वेज रिसेक्शन विद द पेंटागनल वेज रिसेक्शन, प्लस हमने जो लोअर लिड में एक्स्ट्रा स्किन थी उसको भी रिमूव कर दिया. आई कॉल इट ब्लेफेरोप्लास्टी. इज इट क्लियर? This is called Kundt-Szymanowski procedure. कितना मुश्किल है, even I cannot basically pronounce it. Okay, then the next type is if there is a moderate ectropion, okay, and there is the lateral lid that is getting involved. Okay, सो मॉडरेट एक्ट्रोपियन है, ग्रेड टू एक्ट्रोपियन है एंड और ग्रेड थ्री पे जा रहा है एंड हमारी लेटरल लिड जो है वो हमारी निकल रही है. ओके, सो देन आई डू अ प्रोसीजर विच इज कॉल्ड अ लेटरल टार्सल स्ट्रिप. ओके, सो फॉर मॉडरेट एक्ट्रोपियन वॉट आई डू इज आई डू अ प्रोसीजर विच इज कॉल्ड लेटरल टार्सल स्ट्रिप. ओके, जस्ट रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ द प्रोसीजर. एंड इफ देर इज अ मार्क्ड एक्ट्रोपियन, मार्क्ड एक्ट्रोपियन बहुत ज्यादा एक्ट्रोपियन है, सो लेटरली जो हमने टार्सस है जो निकाली है, ओके, एंड देन फिर हमने सूचर किया है वो तो हम करेंगे ही, साथ में हमने जो वो वेज रिसेक्शन किया था वो भी कर देंगे. ओके, सो वी बेसिकली राइट इट डबल वेज रिसेक्शन, डबल वेज रिसेक्शन प्लस लेटरल टार्सल स्ट्रिप. सो दीज आर द प्रोसीजर्स आई राइट इट हेयर, डबल वेज रिसेक्शन विद लेटरल टार्सल स्ट्रिप. दिस इज वॉट वी डू इन द पेशेंट्स ऑफ योर मार्क्ड एक्ट्रोपियन. ओके, नाउ इफ द टियर इज बेसिकली ओनली पंक्टल इवर्जन इज देयर एंड नो लिड लैक्सिटी इज देयर, ठीक है, सो हमारे जो मीडियल था, अभी तो हमने एक बात करी लेटरल कैंथस की, अब हम बात कर रहे हैं मीडियल कैंथस का. सो एक बार फिर से मैं आपको थोड़ा सा रिवाइज करा दूं, दैट दीज आर द लेटरल कैंथस एंड मीडियल कैंथस एंड दे आर द ओरिजिन एंड इंसर्शन ऑफ विच मसल, प्री टार्सल एंड प्री सेप्टल पार्ट ऑफ ऑर्बिक्युलरिस, ठीक है, दे आर द प्री सेप्टल एंड द प्री टार्सल पार्ट ऑफ द ऑर्बिक्युलरिस. सो अभी हमने बताया कि अगर लेटरल कैंथल लैक्सिटी है तो हम लेटरल टार्सल स्ट्रिप प्रोसीजर करते हैं, अगर बहुत ज्यादा है तो वी डू अ ब्लॉक वेज रिसेक्शन ऑल्सो. वॉट हैपन्स इफ देर इज अ मीडियल कैंथल टेंडन लैक्सिटी, सो इफ देर इज अ मीडियल कैंथल टेंडन लैक्सिटी वी सी दैट मीडियल कैंथल तो है वो तो लेंथनिंग हो ही गई है, साथ में पंक्टल इवर्जन है या नहीं है. इफ देर इज अ पंक्टल इवर्जन वॉट आई डू इज आई बेसिकली डू अ कंजंक्टिवोप्लास्टी, मैं थोड़ा सा मीडियली कंजंक्टिवा और टार्सस इसको निकाल दूंगा. व्हाट आई कॉल इट, आई कॉल इट अ मीडियल स्पिंडल प्रोसीजर और मीडियल कंजंक्टिवोप्लास्टी. इफ द लिड लैक्सिटी इज प्रेजेंट बट द मीडियल कैंथल टेंडन इट इज नॉट लैक्स, देन आई डू अ प्रोसीजर विच इज कॉल्ड लेजी टी प्रोसीजर. रिमेंबर द नेम, लेजी टी प्रोसीजर. ओके, सो व्हाट इज द लेजी ट्री प्रोसीजर, आई रिमूव द टार्सस. सो इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट इन द व्हाट इज टार्सस, व्हाट इज द एंटीरियर पार्ट ऑफ द आईलिड, व्हाट इज द पोस्टीरियर पार्ट ऑफ द आईलिड, आई हैव टेकन अ सेशन ऑन द अनअकैडमी लेट्स क्रैक नीट पीजी यूट्यूब चैनल अबाउट द आईलिड एनाटॉमी, यू कैन गो देयर एंड सी द आईलिड एनाटॉमी देयर, इफ यू स्टिल हैव एनी कंफ्यूजन यू कैन आस्क मी. सो मैं एक टार्सस और कंजंक्टिवा का एक पार्ट निकाल देता हूं. ओके, एंड आई बेसिकली जैसे कि मैंने लेटरल कैंथल टेंडन में किया था, ओके, और साथ में मैं एक आईलिड का पार्ट भी निकाल देता हूं. ओके, सो आई रिमूव अ टार्सल कंजंक्टिवा प्लस व्हाट आई डू इज आई डू अ वेज रिसेक्शन ऑफ द लिड ऑल्सो. ओके, सो दिस इज कॉल्ड अ लेजी टी प्रोसीजर. Is it clear? So these are the various ways of treating a ectropion. A ectropion can be treated only surgically. Now, why this is important is that most of these procedure, aap bologe sir, it is very difficult to basically remember these procedures. So trick kya hai? So trick ye hai ki isme jo bhi procedures hain, when we would talk about the ectropion in our coming session tomorrow, so we would be talking about the procedures there. So the ectropion, all the procedures are there named after a surgeon. Okay, so let's say there is a procedure called Jones procedure, there is a any procedure which is there in the ectropion, wo kisi scientist ya kisi doctor ke naam pe tha. Ectropion mein all the procedures that I have basically told you, these are the procedures which are there on the basis of ki आपको क्या चीज निकालनी है. सो व्हाट आर द थिंग्स यू वांट टू रिमूव, व्हाट आर द थिंग्स वेयर यू आर ऑपरेटिंग. सो मोर सिंपलर वन, सो लेट्स सी, यू आर सीइंग देयर इज अ लेटरल टार्सल स्ट्रिप प्रोसीजर, देयर इज अ मीडियल टार्सल स्ट्रिप प्रोसीजर, देयर इज अ लिड टार्सल रिसेक्शन. ओनली नेम्ड प्रोसीजर, ओनली नेम्ड प्रोसीजर इन द एक्ट्रोपियन इज दिस, ये रशियन प्रोसीजर, कोंट सिजमेनोस्की प्रोसीजर. ओके, सो एक ही सिर्फ खाली नेम्ड प्रोसीजर है, नेम्ड सर्जरी है एक्ट्रोपियन में, दैट इज द कोंट सिजमेनोस्की प्रोसीजर. अदरवाइज सब जो है लेटरल टार्सल स्ट्रिप, मीडियल टार्सल स्ट्रिप, मीडियल स्पिंडल प्रोसीजर, लेटरल स्पिंडल प्रोसीजर, डबल वेज रिसेक्शन, बाकी सारे जो हैं वो डिपेंड अपॉन द प्लेस विच यू आर ऑपरेटिंग. इज इट क्लियर एवरीवन? सो बिफोर आई एंड द सेशन आई वुड बी टेलिंग यू द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट क्लिनिकल टेस्ट ऑफ द एक्ट्रोपियन. ओके, सो दो स्टूडेंट्स हु हैव जस्ट जॉइंड नाउ, जस्ट गिव मी अ थम्स अप, जिन्होंने पहला वाली चीज निकल गई थी. सो ये चीजें आपको ध्यान रखनी है कि this is your medial canthal tendon, okay, the medial canthal tendon and the lateral canthal tendon, okay, so ye ek tarah se support karte hain aur ye hamari inferior lid hai. Normally our ectropion there is in your inferior lid. Okay, then we told you that whenever we see about the clinical examination, the first test is pinch test. So hum aapki eyelid margin ko pinch karte hain, अगर 6 मिलीमीटर से ज्यादा चला जाए, सो दिस मीन्स देयर इज अ लोअर लिड लैक्सिटी. द सेकेंड टेस्ट इज वी सी कि एट व्हाट टाइम इट इज गोइंग बैक. अगर ये इंस्टेंटली वापस चला जाता है, ओके, अगर ये इंस्टेंटली वापस चला जाता है, सो दिस मीन्स द पेशेंट इज हैविंग अ गुड लोअर लिड टोन. सो दिस मीन्स द पेशेंट इज नॉट हैविंग लिड लैक्सिटी. बट इफ इट टेक्स सम टाइम टू गो बैक टू इट्स ओरिजिनल पोजिशन, then it means that there is a lower lid laxity. Okay, then the next test is the medial canthal tendon laxity test. Isme hum medial canthal ko laterally leke jate hain aur agar puncta hamara limbus tak pahunch jata hai, iska matlab medial canthal tendon laxity ya fir medial canthal tendon lengthening hai. Okay, so these are the three main tests which you have to basically see and do in a patient of ectropion. Is it clear till now? So thank you very much for attending this session. If you like this session, please tell me in the comment section. If you want more of the clinical procedures, so maine dekha hai ki what we are teaching right now is only theoretical and the MCQ and the clinical based questions, but because you are now not getting the ophthalmic clinics, you are not getting the ophthalmic wards, so our clinical way of treating the patient, that is very less. And one thing that I would say from my all experience for these so many years, what I have seen is never trust the examining body. जब 2010 में हम पेपर देने गए थे तो हमारे यहाँ हमेशा होता था कि वन लाइनर एग्जाम होंगे. When I gave my paper way back of AIIMS in 2010, so we prepared for one liner. They came with the so many of clinical based questions. Then we started preparing for the 2011 exam. We started preparing clinical questions regarding management. Then 2013, what they did was they started the image-based questions. Lots of questions were there on the microbiology. Then we started preparing for the image-based question. So then they came back. Fir NEET PG aa gaya. Usme Prometrics scoring ho gayi. Fir wo one-liner question pe aa gaye. When we started preparing for the one-liner question again, then they gave another type of question, ki assertion reason based question or clinical based question. So one thing is common is they do not have any fixed criteria. So if they do not have any fixed criteria, then how should you prepare? So you prepare for your concept. Okay, so in this session I have told you that how you basically go ahead in the patient of ectropion. ओके, सो इन दिस क्लिनिकल बेस्ड ऑप्थेल्मोलॉजी सीरीज मैं आपको ये बता रहा हूं कि आपके पास पेशेंट आया फ्रॉम हिस्ट्री से, एग्जामिनेशन से लेके एमसीक्यू से लेके मैनेजमेंट तक, उसमें क्या करा जाना चाहिए. तो इस तरह से वेदर यू गेट अ वन लाइनर क्वेश्चन, वेदर यू गेट अ मैनेजमेंट क्वेश्चन, यू गेट अ क्लिनिकल बेस्ड क्वेश्चन, यू वुड बी एबल टू बेसिकली क्रैक द क्वेश्चन. दैट इज द वे योर प्रिपरेशन. विच इज ए ग्रेड प्रिपरेशन दैट वुड बेसिकली गो टू द ए प्लस ग्रेड. आप समझ रहे हो कि आपकी प्रिपरेशन अभी गुड है बट गुड से काम नहीं चलेगा, आपको आपकी प्रिपरेशन गुड से एक्सीलेंट पे जानी है. सो तभी आपने देखा होगा कि मेरे लेक्चर्स जैसे भी हो, यस डेफिनेटली आई एग्री दैट आई गो ऑन द टफर साइड बट आई ट्राई टू इनोवेट एवरी डे. सो एवरी डे बिकॉज वी हैव अ वेरी वेरी बैड सिचुएशन इन दिल्ली, वी आर हैविंग सो मच केसेस एवरी डे. वन माई रिलेटिव्स, माई वेल बींग्स, माई फेलो डॉक्टर्स, दे आर ऑन सो मच प्रेशर, देर आर लॉट्स ऑफ कैजुअलिटीज गोइंग ऑन. Every day I go to the, my family is with me, not with me. So every day I go to the OPD. I pray to the God that everything should be all right. मैं ये देखता हूँ कि मैंने कल क्या किया. I am so grateful to the God कि whatever He has basically given me till now, I write it in my diary. Then I write what should I do on this day, on 6th of May 2021. What is the thing that I have to do extra? I have to do something which I have not done yesterday. I do not know what would be the result, but I have to do something. I have to increase my skill. And how I would increase my skill? I have to go into that domain that is unexplored. Okay, the clinical base. I am teaching for last 8.5 years. I have not seen that the patients, the students having a good clinical approach. So my basic aim in this clinical case discussion series would be to give you that extra clinical knowledge. Not only you have to basically clear your PG exam or your optometry intern exam, you have to be a good doctor, a good clinician. A person may be having a very high degree, but his clinical approach may be deficient. And I do not want to make a person who is having a deficiency in the clinical approach. That is my basic aim for this clinical case discussion. Thank you very much for joining this discussion. Good night and Jai Hind. And before I end this session, I would be having another clinical case-based discussion today at, let's say, 10:30 p.m., where I would be talking about how to basically approach a patient of esotropia. Okay, so a patient of a manifest squint, how should I go? So be there. Squint is something which you always get scared about, and the questions that are asked are the most simple ones. If you like the session, please write it in the comment section. Please subscribe for our channel. Please click on the like button also. So the more the likes, the more the views that we get. You can share this video also with your friends. The more likes, the more shares, the more views that we would get, I would be having more approach and more access to taking more of the videos. So this is just my humble request to you. If you can just like the button and you can share it with your friends, your good friends who are preparing for you, it would be great for me. Thank you very much. Good night and Jai Hind.